But the last we were no Mau Ruth Waitera Nene Kate Madenga Lukua PC. Akasema tupewe eka tano tano ngata farm mpaka wa leo atukuiona kwa sababu baba yetu Uhuru ni mtu anapenda mchezo. Tunamwambia ongera, anatupenda na tunajua yeye akisema kitu tuombe huwa tunatimiza yale amesema, kwa maana tunapenda nchi yetu. Hatutaki wachezaji yetu kwenda kukimbilia nchi nyingine. Hii ni nchi yetu na tuko na amani. Kwa haya yote mimi nasema Mungu abariki na tunashukuru Mungu atuweke hai. Mungu abariki Kenya yetu wakati hii ya corona. Tuchunge hata hii inateremka kidogo, tuchunge kwa sababu corona ni riri na nchi yetu tunangangana. Tunashukuru hakuna mchezaji amekufa, lakini wale wamefuka Mungu awasaidie awarehemu. Kwa hiyo yote nasema asanteni sana, Mungu awabariki.
Yes. And that's Rose Tata Muya, a sprinter 400 meters. She holds the national record from 1987 over the distance. Billy Conchela, a legend, you know, and one of the men who put the Kenyan name out there on the map in the 800 meters. Billy, thank you so much for joining us. AK is celebrating 70 years. What a journey would you trace, keeping in mind that the footsteps in AK are also the same as your Nyayo Zako?
Yeah, you see, the thing is, what happens is like what we have done all this time is like, when Kipruto Chumo won the first 800 meters, he actually showed that Kenya was alive. But also, when I came in, I was the first African to win the 800 meters world title. Sasa, that record stayed until last year. We broke it last year in September in Doha. So the thing is, it's like it shows that we are able to do a lot of things. Actually, the way I want to put this thing of celebration of 70th year, it's like, you see, Jomo Kenyatta lit our star. All of us, including Kibaki, na Moi, na wengine, is just to polish that star to continue to shine. That's what athletic has done. All what we're doing is polishing that star to continue. In Uhuru Kenyatta, na wengine wote, that's what we're all doing, to make sure that that star stays bright and is always going. The thing is about youngsters and the future of Athletic Kenya, we have a lot of potential. And we hope that we can be able to encourage youngsters to be able to come and become like Billy Conchela. The problem is, it's not happening nowadays. Why it is going on? There's something going on because we are losing.
And most of Billy, over your distance, it's looking at where we're headed. The hope is there, the people are there, but...
Yeah, the 800 meters is sort of... They have to do the things that we used to do when I was in Upper Hill High School here. And those are the things that Athletic Kenya used to do with Isaiah Kiplanga. They need to recall and see what we did, like the AA meetings and all these things. Now it's become too business and too commercial. And we need to go back and also to try to have a whole country site, not just one particular place. Because you see, if we look at that narrow-minded, we'll be able to miss other champions from different places. Billy Conchela just came out because I was in Nairobi here. Otherwise, if I was herding Maasai cows, I think I would have just continued being a warrior out there. So the thing is, they should look at other places like Turkana, Kajiado, and different places in Northeastern. I'm sure there's some more farers out there. So that's the thing is, we need to find that kind of an outlook. AK is doing a good job. They've been working very hard to bring everybody together. But we need to open up now and think out of the box.
Yes. Yes. And of course, you're talking about opening up and going out of the box. Those are one of the sentiments that the AK chair spoke about yesterday, expanding. Yes. And also one of the major issues that he talked about was the art of taking the sport to the people, you know, and then also being able to maybe remunerate this athletes who made this today's event possible, the athletes who championed or pioneered Kenya's footprints on its global stage.
Yes.
And most of them, sorry to say, but that they're going through a rough patch, you know, and there's been a proposal of having an insurance scheme for them. How can this be best be done, a suitable way to do this? Maybe I'm just about your thought.
No, I think they can do it. If they just need to go back. Yes, right, today is just a reminder of how we did it and why we did it. That's why it's sort of a nostalgia. Because you see, the thing is, they have looked at us like, Mbona, we were great. What is happening? And our graph now is going down. So what is the problem? It can be done because, you see, the thing is, if they need to nurture from the ground and help the children to start believing that they can be like Billy and all these things. They can do it. But you see, the thing is, and try to leave the commercial part of it out. Let us make the sports more enjoyable for the children and more fun, and they can be able to make it. And also, bring people like us. I mean, we have so much knowledge. Maybe a PhD here in athletics, but not maybe in the books of economics or science or something. But in terms of athletics, maybe I have 5 PhDs. So those are the things, because there is those small tricks of the trade that you can only show people how to do it. And you can't really explain it. So the thing is, generally I see we need to go back to those PE days, the PE times. And that's myself, I was discovered from a PE class with my PE teacher to encourage those PE, because that's where we can be able to catch talent at an early age. And also just put more support, because you see, if you look at that, in my narrow county, children don't have shoes, they don't have clothes yet. And I hope that even the governors themselves, they need to be trained to like sports, so that sports is a powerful and is biggest business in the world, and we can be able to do many things. But the government cannot come there and manage you out there. The governors and the MCAs, those are the people who can be able to help us, and the children from the school groups.
Yes. Billy, thank you so much, and I cannot let you go without taking you down memory lane. Yeah. And one proud moment when you set the record. Does this stand out as your proudest moment in your career? When you set the record over the distance, and is this the only moment that you can mark as your proudest moment of their play?
You see, my races were very tactical. They were not just ilang goofy. It was very tactical and highly planned, and I knew who was running, who was my competitor, and I knew how fast they were. So I knew how to run my races, and I never let people go far that I knew they're strong. If they are weak, I stay far behind. Then I know I'll catch them. But you see, there's some strong people like Paul Ereng. You can't let Paul Ereng go ahead in front of you. But you see, the problem with Paul Ereng is he has speed just like me. He likes to sit behind me and try to outkick me. But sometimes if he goes in front, I make sure that I follow him, because you see, it's a hard character to catch. But others are not as fast as Paul Ereng. So my races were very tactical. The 87 World Championship in Rome was very nice, because you see, it encouraged even Moi to come, the president, to come to the stands to cheer us. So it was a very memorable time for me. And the record stayed for 32 years. So I still, that was my memorable. And this is the gold medal for Rome. Yeah, this one. That's it, 87. And it stayed for 32 years. You see, it's still clean. I keep it very well. Yes,
thank you so much, Billy, and all the best. Uh-huh. And you're the think tank of athletics in the country.
We
keep positioning ourselves, and we'll be there.
God bless Kenya. Yeah. We have a greater future.
Thank you so much, Billy Conchella, you know, who has been speaking here at the Nyayo National Stadium, where Athletics Kenya is marking 70 years since its formation in 1950. And just maybe a little bit history of the founding chairman of this particular federation was David Esken, who also donated this particular piece of land in 1964, which was handed to the incoming chair, to the second chairman of the federation. By then, it was known as KAAA, is Kenya Athletics Amateur Association. And of course, that was Musembi Mbadi, the second chairman, who took over the ownership, who was handed over this particular piece of land donated by the first office, which was led by Chairman David Esken, as well as Haji Evans, who donated 23 acres. That where National Stadium sits, and also the adjacent where the headquarters of Athletics Kenya at Riadha House is currently situated. I'll be handing you over to Amfa Apidi to take over the second part of this live broadcast from Nyayo National Stadium, where today's chief guest is a Sports Cabinet Secretary Ambassador Mina Mohammed, who has already arrived. Amfa Apidi will be taking us through the second phase of this broadcast. Over to you, Amfa.
Thank you very much, Bernard Okumu, right at the Nyayo National Stadium. Good morning, wherever you're joining us. It is the 70th anniversary celebrations of Athletics Kenya happening here at the Nyayo National Stadium, and from the setup, it looks all set. And of course, having seen some of the greats being interviewed by Bernard Okumu, some of them being Billy Conchela, Charles Asati of the famous 4x400 meters in the yesteryears, to be precise, 1972 Olympic Games, then arguably the mother of athletics here in the country, Rose Tatamoya, famous for the 400 meter sprints. Welcome once again. My name is Amfa Pidi, ready to take you through the highlights of the day and also just keep you posted on what's happening. You can see the chief guest for the day, Ambassador Amina Mohammed, already at the venue and, of course, celebrating the 70th anniversary of Athletics Kenya. Remember, it all started in 1950 with being named the Kenya Amateur Athletics Association in 1950. Of course, the British volunteer Sir Archie Evans, along with Sir Derek Erskine, first chairman of Athletics Kenya, then called Kenya Amateur Athletics Association, started it all. And since then, it's been success after success in terms of positioning this country as a sporting destination. It's been a long, long journey in terms of Kenya being the great. Ambassador Amina Mohammed there being taken through a tour of some of the stands put together to celebrate the long journey that we've come with. Having toured some of the stands earlier on, very interesting to note that right there you can see one of the former chairmen of Athletics Kenya. Not many know that is Senator Sam Ongeri, who was the chairman Kenya Amateur Athletics Association between 1974 and 1984. They are taking Ambassador Amina Mohammed through some of the highlights of Athletics Kenya. Just to run you through some of the chairmen who've taken over the reins of this famous federation, to start off was Derek Erskine in 1950 through to 1964. Then Musembi Mbathi took over in 1964 to 1968. Bartonjo Rotich was then elected chairman between 1968 and 1972. Then Charles Mukora took over in 1972 through to 1974. Then the current senator, Sam Ongeri, professor, took over between 1974 and 1984, leading this association then called Kenya Triple S, which was Kenya Amateur Athletics Association. We are seeing CS Sports Ambassador Amina Mohammed there signing the visitors book just to acknowledge her presence within the venue. After Sam Ongeri, then Paul Boit was at the helm of Athletics Kenya, then Kenya Amateur Athletics Federation Association, between 1984 and 1982. Then the late Isaiah Kiplagat took over from 1992 to 2015. After that, we've seen Jackson Tuwei, the current AK president, taking over to date. It's been a sequence, and interestingly indeed, we've only had about eight AK leaders, and since then it's been success after success, like mentioned earlier on. Interestingly indeed, you know, when we look at athletics, it is known to be the mother of Kenyan sports. Many argue that it is the backbone of Kenyan sports here in the country, where every Kenyan always known to be an athletic an athlete in the different areas that they do come from. Athletics has positioned this country to be a sporting destination wherever you go across the world. The first question when you introduce yourself as a Kenyan is always athletics. I remember sometimes a couple of years back when I was in Addis Ababa, Ethiopia, the first question at the airport, Kenyan, the first question they asked was Paul Tergat. Remember the rivalry between Paul Tergat and Haile Gebrselassie, known to be one of the greatest rivalry, but since then the two have remained to be very big and great friends indeed, showing that sports actually is a unifying factor, not just in a country, but across the globe. Very, very interesting indeed, as we can see that CS Ambassador Amina Mohamed being taken through some of the stunts put together. Just to give you a glimpse of this, the stunts put together, we have a South Rift, we have National Police Service stand. Remember, National Police producing some of the great athletes here in the country. We also have other stands, Kenya Prisons stand. Prisons also actually hosting the prison stand is the great Catherine Ndereba. Catherine Ndereba, very, very you know, prominent indeed. Catherine Ndereba acknowledged and being, you know, given a state commendation over the weekend during the Jamhuri Day celebrations. Catherine Ndereba leading the prison's stand, indeed one of the greatest for Kenya. We all know that Catherine Ndereba is the first, actually when you look at Ndereba, she's the first woman gold medalist in marathon. That was in the World Championships in 2003. And since then, she's been one of the best when it comes to opening and leading the way for athletes here in the country, and women to be precise, because after that we've seen the emergence of Mary Kaitanyi, Vivian Cheruiyot, the current world record holder, Bridget Koskei, not forgetting Edna Kiplagat, but all those are following the steps of the great Catherine Ndereba, who indeed respected in the country and was over the weekend given head of state commendation during the Jamhuri Day celebrations here at the Nyayo National Stadium, presided over by His Excellency the President Uhuru Kenyatta over the weekend. But it's been a journey for Kenya in terms of being a greater athletic nation. We all know that it all started in 1950, but when we look at you know, the revolution of how it's been, some of the great that we've seen around include Kipchoge Keino, who is present here today. Kipchoge Keino, one of the great, you know, the great athletes here in the country, pioneer Kipchoge Keino, the first Kenyan to win two gold medals in the Olympic Games, 1968 Mexico, where he won the 1500 meters. And of course, not forgetting, you know, another great there on your screen, that's Wilson Kiprugut Arap Chumo, who won the 800 meters, then called 880 yards, in a time of 1 minute 44 seconds. First ever Kenyan to win an Olympic Games medal in Tokyo, Japan, 1964. That is Wilson Kiprugut Arap Chumo, one of the great Kenyan sportsmen in the country. We celebrate them because they positioned us to where we are today. CS Ambassador Amina Mohamed admiring some of you know, the athletics Kenya revolutions in terms of pictorials that have been put there. It's like a museum, I tell you. I know our cameraman will be looking at some of the images that have been paraded there, just to give a history of how you know, it's all been going round, how it all started to where we are today. And just mentioning some of the greats, like mentioned Wilson Kiprugut Arap Chumo here in the stadium, not forgetting Kipchoge Keino, first Kenyan to also win two Olympic gold medals in 1968, 1500 meters, and 1972, 3000 meters steeplechase in Munich. That clearly is a testimony that the steeplechase tradition did not just start the other day. It's been a Kenyan domain ever since we started off in the early 70s. To date, it's always believed to be a Kenyan affair, where everybody just knows that it is a Kenyan, you know, Kenya's race to win. The question normally is, what order is it going to be? Is it going to be a clean sweep, or is it just going to be one or two Kenyans in it? But it's always believed to be a Kenyan domain. But just to give you a glimpse of why Athletics Kenya is, you know, taken as one of the best federations here in the country is because athletics has positioned us across the world as one of the best. In fact, our athletes hold current world records, and when we talk about that, we all know that Eliud Kipchoge, the best marathon runner ever in the world, actually holds the world record in marathon at 2 hours 1 minute and 39 seconds in Berlin 2018. Also, the first man to run under 2 hours, though not sanctioned by World Athletics, but in Guinness books, he is known, or he is given the credit as having been the first man to run a marathon under 2 hours. CS Ambassador Amina Mohamed, taken through the Costa region stand. Remember, when you talk athletics, Kenya, we talk about the regions where we have South Rift, North Rift, Nairobi, not forgetting Nyanza, South Rift, I've mentioned that, Western, very, very strong regions indeed. And when we have the National Athletics Championships here in Nairobi or wherever it is in the country, it's always very, very tough. Our athletes always say that it is tougher to win a Kenyan qualifying race than go out there to compete in the actual qualifications or in the actual races. We can see former chairman of Kenya Amateur Athletics Association, Professor Sam Ongeri, taking Ambassador Amina Mohamed through some of the stands lined up there, that taken through the National Police Service stand. And as mentioned, Sam Ongeri was, Professor Ongeri was the chairman Kenya Amateur Athletics Association between 1974 and 1984. What an honor to also have him around to just be part of this 70th anniversary celebrations. And of course, some of the success that we are enjoying today was a result of the good leadership that they had. And of course, talking about we are talking about the former chairman Derek Exen from 1950 to 1964, Musembi Mbathi 1964 to 1968. Then we had Bartonjo Rotich, who took over between 1968 and 1972, Charles Mukora 1972 and 1974, Professor Sam Ongeri between 1974 and 1984. Then Paul Boit took over between 1984 and 1992. Then the late Isaiah Kiplagat took over between 1992 and 2015. Handing over or taking over the reins between 2015 to date is current chairman Jackson Tuwei. Athletics Kenya Federation, one of the best run federations in the country, and of course having their headquarters built and properly run, complete with a museum within proximity of Nyayo National Stadium. Of course, there we can see the current chairman, retired Lieutenant General Jackson Tuwei, with CS for Sports Ambassador Amina Mohamed. They are just being taken through some of the stands that we have that have been set up here at the Nyayo National Stadium. It's a great honor indeed for Athletics Kenya to be celebrating 70 years of success. Despite all that has been happening, one or two individuals have tried tarnishing the good sport, going into doping, but majority of Kenyans always go out there and win clean. Very, very good indeed that majority always decide that we win fair, we work hard, and ensure that by the end of the day, our pride still remains. Olympic Games history remains that out of all the Olympics, Kenya has managed to win 103 medals, and of the 103, definitely it is a proper indeed. We are seeing CS Ambassador Amina Mohamed, they are just being taken through some of the stands, and as I was mentioning, 103 medals, of all those 96 have come from athletics. That clearly tells that athletics remains our strong backbone, one of the strongest backbone in Kenya's sporting history. good indeed, because when we look at all that athletics, Kenya, as we speak, has been nominated among the six finalists of the Best Federations Award in Athletics Kenya. And of course, we are wishing and hoping that Athletics Kenya will win the Best Run Federation in the world. Remember, they have been nominated among five others, Kenya being amongst the six nominated by World Athletics in terms of Best Run Federations. And it is our belief that hopefully we will be given that nod and winning that Best Run Athletics Federation. This is as a result of having hosted a very good intercontinental tour here in Nairobi, the Kip Keino Classic that was held here in Nairobi. The success of that Athletics Kenya still remains as one of the best. And when we look at all that has happened, we go back to Athletics Kenya staging some of the best events globally here in the world, a feat not seen by any other federation here in the country. We go back to 2007 when Athletics Kenya hosted the World Cross Country Championships here in Nairobi. Interestingly indeed, not a Kenyan won that race, but we well remember Zesenai Tadese of Eritrea winning the World Cross-Country Championships here in Kenya that was held in Mombasa. But the talking point was the hot humidity and the sunny conditions that were in Mombasa that then clear favorite Kenenisa Bekele, who was expected to win, could not even finish the race. Not just hosting the World Cross Country Championships, we've seen Athletics Kenya host the World Under 18 Championships here in Nairobi at the Moi International Center a couple of years back in 2017, dubbed the greatest and the best ever junior championships in the world. Fans thronged the stadium, and of course a very, very good performance by the Kenyan team and all the athletes that took part in that. We've also seen successful senior Africa championships held here in Nairobi, and all that credit to Athletics Kenya having hosted that and positioned Kenya as one of the best global sporting destinations in the world. How can we forget that Athletics Kenya
tonight on KBC Channel 1.
Are you a Morian? Your doom is in front of you. Not even God can save you now.
How dare you not bow down as a mark of respect to the great Chief Kicha? He should apologize by touching the feet of our Lord now. You will pay for your misdeed.
I've heard that a boy was found swimming in the sea by a merchant's boat.
A boy? Does anyone know who that boy was?
Next episode of
Umevalia maridadi kweli kweli. Na sikilida yako hii mvipi?
Sina shida tena.
Ha?
Shida zangu zote naziambia kwa heri. Latifa, kwani umeshinda mamilioni? Hii ni zaidi ya mamilioni nakwambia. Mpenzi wangu wa moyo, yoja kumchukua papa hapa. Twenda zetu ngambo. Sikiza. Mwambie Mr. Rocks niko hapa, aje anichukue.
Mimi hapa, Mr. Rocks, mwenyewe.
Hivi nikawa nchanganya na changanyikiwa. Sikuelewi.
Usichanganyikiwe mwana.
Kikulacho jamani.
KBC, in collaboration with the Kenya Institute of Curriculum Development, is broadcasting enhanced out-of-class learning on radio, television, and online. Catch the lessons every weekday on KBC Channel 1 from 2 to 4 p.m., on KBC English Service and 15 FM from 9:15 a.m. to 5 p.m., and Radio Taifa from 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. KBC English Service, Radio Taifa and 15 FM are also available countrywide on the free-to-air Signet digital TV platform, or log on to www.kbc.co.ke for live streaming, or download the KBC Online app on Google Play Store. Kenya Broadcasting Corporation, ensuring learning no matter what.
Tonight on KBC Channel 1.
Somebody took Anna.
Take it easy, Fabiola. We'll find her. Have you looked everywhere?
That guy stole my bag! Stop, baby! He's a thief!
You think Francisco did this?
To be honest, my love, I do. What are you doing?
I'm going to take a little picture of her and send it to Ramon.
Why, Sophia? Why are you doing this?
This is a lesson for me. I want you to know how hurt and shaken up I was when you chose Fabiola over me. What are you doing? Are you stealing money from me?
El paraíso conocimos.
In love with Ramon. Next on.
Baby, when the bright lights start to fade, fire up your lighter, float on with the wave.
I love my girl to some reggae. It's been a long day. Taxi driver, watch out of me here like me no know about choir.
Everybody wanna be like me, forget your troubles and rock with me.
everything that I do, I go to sawa kwa macho yako.
Unataka kuwako.
Ati nini?
Why are you people shouting?
Are you okay?
Mwanamke ninakuona sana. Ni wanaume hapa Mombasa wameisha.
Ni nini mbaya?
Nowadays we have so many unfaithful people.
Need to talk about her every time we are together.
I'd be very careful the way you address me.
Sako zinakuangaje? Wezi kada kambili hata bila kuteta.
We will all sign new contracts.
And I am supposed to be briefed.
What?
Thank you, Jinga.
Oof.
KBC Channel 1.
You ready for the big fight? I know you're going to win.
Hey. You know nini?
Wapi?
Nimeona kuweka hii kitu kwa maji ya amani. Hii ni nini?
Next episode of
Umevalia maridadi kwa kweli. Na sikilida yako hii mvipi?
Sina shida tena.
Ha?
Shida zangu zote naziambia kwa heri.
Latifa, kwani umeshinda mamilioni?
Hii ni zaidi ya mamilioni nakwambia. Mpenzi wangu wa moyo, yuaja kunichukua papa hapa. Twenda zetu ngambo. Sikiza. Mwambie Mr. Rocks niko hapa, aje anichukue.
Mimi hapa, Mr. Rocks, mwenyewe.
Hivi nikawa nchanganya, nachanganyikiwa. Sikuelewi.
Usichanganyikiwe mwana.
Kikulacho jamani.
Tonight on KBC Channel 1.
Are you a Morian? Your doom is in front of you. Not even God can save you now.
How dare you? Not bowed down as a mark of respect to the great Chief Kicha. He should apologize by touching the feet of our Lord.
Yes, indeed, and we're still at the Nyayo National Stadium, and as you can see, maybe Zadok would just pan and show you what's exactly happening here. Of course, this is where the Cabinet Secretary for Sports, Ambassador Amina Mohammed, is currently touring various stalls or various regions that have put up exhibitions here, where they are showcasing their memorabilia, various memorabilia, and this includes medals and some of the shoes that were used by respective athletes from these regions. Of course, we're talking about the 12 regions and four institutions that form up the Athletics Kenya, and that's the administrative wise. Of course, the four institutions, the National Police Service, the KDF, as well as the JC and the police. So, I mean, as you can see, there is the North Rift, the Western Stand, and the earlier on the minister opened or rather unveiled the play commemorating the 70 years here, and just behind me Zadok, we having the universities region, which is one of the major regions that form a part and parcel of the Athletics Kenya, and maybe we could be speaking to them and see what they've been able to achieve over time. And thank you so much, gentlemen. Sorry to interrupt you, but maybe if you could join me in this wonderful discussion that we're having here. And this the universities Honcho, or the top organ of the University's Athletics Association, is here, and on my right is my former lecturer at the Kenya Polytechnic. Back then it used to be so, and it is Technical University of Kenya. Thank you so much, gentlemen, the chairman and the vice chair, and also Mr. Cheng, the secretary. Yes, yes. And maybe you could start with the chair, you know. You could tell us about the steps, or rather the achievements that the university have contributed to the 70 years history that we're marking today.
Yeah, thank you very much. The universities have made a huge contribution to Athletics Kenya by providing students who are actually at the universities, both locally and internationally, to compete in the Olympic Games. And we have some of the top athletes like Paul Reng, we have Fatuel Kemayo, Mike Boyd, who has been a lecturer at Kenyatta University. So we are saying we have a huge talent that have contributed a lot in the medal hall in the last 70 years.
Yes.
And we are hoping that going forward, mm-hmm. our students will keep improving in performance, mm-hmm. and we shall also continue providing the opportunities.
Yes. And what has been the challenge as we look towards the next 70 years? The 70 is done, now we have to focus.
One challenge
that
I can just say is we would like to have one stadium within the universities, and that is something that we really want to request the government to consider, putting up at least one stadium in one of the universities, preferably a university around the equator. And that will provide an opportunity for students to converge there and compete at international level. Yeah.
How would putting up the university around the equator region be helpful to the growth and inspiring development of athletics or sports in general?
I think when you talk about the equator, it's all about accessibility, because our universities are spread across the country, you know. So, but as we talk, there's a stadium that is upcoming at Kenyatta University, courtesy of the Under 18 2017. Although it's not yet complete, but we're hoping soon the government will complete the project. Now, the other issue would be the issue of scholarships, because most of our talent, our athletes, have been trooping to the United States and the European countries. But we have seen local universities, Kenyatta University, Masinde Muliro University, Strathmore University next door, you know, offering scholarships. So though they are not like full scholarship, but we want a situation where our talented athletes can be offered full scholarships so that they can study and around and represent our country in international competitions. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yes. And you've been on the ground, I've met you severally, you know, and what would you say is the probable talent. Right now, should we say that we are getting there of the amount of talent or potential that's lying in campuses, in universities?
It's very true. It's very true. The problem that we are facing as Kenyans, once students get into the university, they try to deviate from their real talents. But I can tell you, look at people like Omanyala, Ferdinand. You see? So look at people like that, and if you find out group of Colin Somai, these are guys whom we know very well. They are like people whom we call the guys who others can learn from. At the moment, if I can tell you, students are beginning to realize that even if they have degree, there is something extra which they need to put on the table. And especially those who are talented have now become serious with their athletics. Unlike the long time when people thought athletics was just meant for people who are just using their natural talent. Now they are trying to canvas their academic talent and their sports talent. And I believe that walking into the next millennium, walking to the near future, the universities, the way my colleagues have told you, have embraced scholarships, whereby you are sporting talents. Like Zetec University is now giving full scholarships. Masinde Muliro is giving full scholarships in all the areas, and I know it will be better.
I think I'm with the perfect people to ask this question, and maybe I don't know who will answer it, but looking at where the sports is moving, sports science is very key as universities. What kind of frontline are championing this?
Thank you very much. I am very proud to have some of our elite athletes who just completed their running career and they joined the universities to have another double career. And we're very proud to introduce Milka Chemos, world champion and a bronze medalist in the Olympics. Maybe she can say something.
Mm-hmm. Yes, Milka, you've been on the track and it is moment to tell those who are yet to come or those who are just trying to do what you did on the track that it's all possible. How possible is it?
Okay, if you balance yourself as an athlete, like for me now, I'm doing my undergraduate in Moi University. I'm doing sports management. I think it is only discipline for an athlete. If you are disciplined enough and you balance yourself, you will get that time. And I'll encourage our athletes to take this education as a key. Because you can't be an athlete forever. At least you must have something at the table. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
For your course, what you're undertaking, what are you looking? How are you going to transfer the knowledge? In what areas and maybe how soon? Because this what you're doing and I believe you have plans for the course and education.
Okay, I'm doing sports management in Moi University, Eldoret, West Campus. And I think after my graduation, I think this sports management will help me so much because I've been in this industry for sports. And I think it helped me so much to know much about sports. Yeah, and I'll also encourage our athletes to do this sports management, especially athletes who are active and those retired ones.
Yes. And this just an encouragement for former athletes to take up, go back to class and get their knowledge they have amassed over years on the track to classroom and also transfer it to the upcoming talent and all the best maker to most.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Yes, Chair, thank you so much for your time and all the best as you mull over the proposals to take the Kenyan athletics to the next frontier.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Yes, and of course, we've been speaking to the University Games Regions Chair. And of course, as you can, maybe Zadok will just take a walk with me and I'll show you some of the regions here that are on display here. For instance, the marking the 70th anniversary. This is the KDF region where we have one of their front men who did champion their footprint in the national, on the national and as well as global stages. Naftali Temoman, who won Kenya's first ever Olympic Games gold medal, and that was in the 10,000 meters at the 1968 Mexico Games. And
Of course, we'll be talking to we'll be speaking to a couple of the athletes currently in the Kenya Defence Forces, who are championing the cause, you know. And I'm joined by Helen Obiri, and we're talking about marking the 70 years of athletics in the country, and definitely KDF has been an integral part. It's a region, I mean, one of the four institutions that also make up the Athletics Kenya. And maybe Obiri, with your stellar performances, stellar record, impeccable record, you know, on track, what the celebrations today, what kind of a journey does it mirror for you?
For me, it's a golden opportunity which KDF has given me to Athletics Kenya to represent a country. And with the mark, like 70 years in athletics, it gives us opportunity to celebrate and maybe to recognize the retired athletes and the upcoming athletes and the current athletes. So it's very good example for me to work hard, maybe to be like role model when I retire from athletics.
Becoming a role model means you're guiding someone. What's the most key thing that you tell people, or you like to tell people when you're guiding them, when you become a role model?
You know, when you become a role model, you must say, like, you must guide the upcoming athletes and the young talents to put them together and maybe to start like a training camp, and to tell them the most important thing is to work extra hard. In athletics, there's no shortcut. You must work hard, and the discipline is the key to success. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yes, and of course your stellar performance at this season. How old you capital? You began the 2020-2021 season with the win at Machakos during the cross country. How does the 2021 season pan out for you?
It's a good opportunity. Maybe you are going to expect 2021. There's a lot of competition. There's Olympics. So my main target is to focus in Olympic Games, of which I missed a medal last in 2016. So for now, I'm going to work extra hard. You know, when you want to achieve something, you have to work extra hard so that you can achieve what you want. So for me, I'm now focusing to Olympics 2021.
Yes, and maybe quickly, how pioneering were the athletes that we are celebrating today, those who started all in 1952 up to date? How pioneering were they? How important are they to our history?
You know, in our days, we were watching them running, so for me, it's a golden opportunity to meet them here. So it's a golden opportunity, actually. I can say that I was just at this Paul Target, some retired athletes. So it's a golden opportunity so they can give us example how they used to run, how used to hit, how used to stay, and the disciplines.
Yes.
Yeah.
And also, thank you so much, Helen Obiri.
Thank you.
All the best in 2021 season.
Thank you.
Keep your candy. Thank you so much. Also, you're with us, and we are glad to speak to you. I mean, the last question that I asked Helen was about how today's journey, how the last 7 years have been, and it's today's generation athletes like you, Kandia, who are going to take it to the next level. What's going on in your mind when you know that you're the person who is charged with delivering this journey to the next generation? How important is the 7 years to you today?
Yes, this is a great day. Actually, the Athletic Federation and the Kenya in general have molded it and did it to become a very big celebration that in 70 years we have been having runners all from the old men up to the generation of us now. We are very grateful that they have organized such a celebration to show that Kenya, we are still continuing on with this athletics. As far as from 1952 to this 2020, it has been a very long journey. And to this far, we are now celebrating. And actually, we are still showing great things from that far until this 2020.
Yes, and as a young man who is Kenya's future today, what do you copy from that?
What I copy from these legends for 1950s is that let us train hard and make our Kenya proud, and we market athletics that it's a good talent, and we must develop it through hard training and perseverance.
Yes. And speaking on their behalf, of course, you mentioned about perseverance. What else? What other challenges do you think today's athlete must overcome to be better?
Yes, I know training is not easy, but an athlete, a serious athlete as well, has to be committed on this job, and again, he must have discipline and must respect the colleagues and work hard for the achievement.
Yes, and of course, we won't let you go, Kandia, before speaking about your plan for 2021 season. I mean, 2020 was a year that was tough for you, just like it was for many athletes. How rough was it for you in 2020 as you look forward to 2021 season?
Yes, 2020 has been a very tough year because the COVID pandemic has arisen very early at the year. And it disrupted all the calendar, every program, and athletes actually they suffered a lot. And the coming 2021, we are hoping for good that we have to get a lot of races. Actually, we are focusing now to attend the Olympics games and major big championships, of which we will raise the Kenyan flag.
Thank you so much, Kibiot Kandia, and all the best as you look forward to 2021 season.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.
And yes, indeed, looking at the celebrations here, and of course, various guests have attended these particular celebrations, and our key guest among them is Jackson Mandago, the governor for Uasin Gishu County. Thank you so much, Bwana Governor, for joining us, and your county or your region is home to all, if not all, but all the talents that we're celebrating, a very, very influential region when it comes to athletics, Bwana Governor. And the last 7 years that AK is celebrating today would not be possible if various things could not happen, you know, various stuff could not have been done to enable them, give them room and space to train and become better. And as we mark, as AK marks 7 years, Bwana Governor, what is going on in your mind as far as making Uasin Gishu become a more region that not only creating trailblazers but champions who rule the world?
Thank you very much. First and foremost, let me say that to the Ministry of Sports and AK, congratulations for celebrating athletics at 70. I think this is the first event of its kind that recognizes those who have brought honor to this country through sports. And today, as we celebrate AK at 70, as a region from Uasin Gishu County, and generally, I can speak on behalf of NOREP, the North Rift Economic Bloc, where I'm the chair, that brings together most of majority of those counties that have actually produced these champions, is to say that we really appreciate the role they have played. And the reason why we are here is to actually celebrate them and tell the world that we have men and women of honor through sports who have made a serious contribution to the development of this country. Secondly, as we celebrate AK at 70, we are not only celebrating what we have in the current, but we are also looking into the future. And into the future, as county governments of the region, we are investing in sports facilities with the hope that not so long into the future, we should be able to host international events in the country so that our Kenya fan base can have opportunity to witness some of these sports live. We've seen Kenyans have made a mark in terms of world records all over the globe, but we would like some of those records now to be broken in our own soils in Kenya. And that's why, as county government of Uasin Gishu, we are investing in 64 stadium from scratch to end, and we have already budgeted $1.2 billion for that stadium. Nandi County is in the process of completing Kipkeno Stadium. At Geo Marakwet, they're in the process of completing Kamarin Stadium. And so, as a region, we are also looking into tapping sports, not just for entertainment, for talent, but we are also looking at how then do we also use this sport as a tourism attraction in the country. So as county government of Uasin Gishu, we're investing on a high-altitude training center. And with that high-altitude training center, we want to give opportunity to young people who don't have a chance to go to these established camps where they have managers and agents. But we as government want to give them that platform and also bring in other athletes from other countries to come and train with our champions as a way of promoting and inspiring sports tourism.
How urgent are the facilities required?
Like three years ago. And that is why we are really trying to push even national government to complete like Kipchoge, Keno and Eldoret. But already for us in the county government, we've already put a tender out for 64 stadium. It's a contract that's supposed to be complete in the next 18 months. We are hopeful that we are going to get a serious contractor. You know, most of these sports facilities you see lagging behind, government had already put funds. Government had already brought in a contractor, but the contractors have let us down. But we hope that we are going to get good contractors to complete the projects.
And of course, one of the, as we celebrate the athletes who trailblazed, one of the key issues or sticking point has been on their welfare. And listening to yesterday's Jack Dway, the chairman of the Athletics Kenya speak, was one of the things that they plan to do is maybe enroll this, some of the athletes who are going through a rough path in their lives into a medical scheme. What would be your thought on this? Have you thought, given it a thought?
Is definitely a good idea. What we are doing ourselves as our small contribution is actually to train them, because you realize that a majority of these athletes are people who through sports have also been able to create wealth, but somehow in the process a majority of them have lost that wealth. Now what we are doing in our department of sports is actually training them on financial management, so that the little resources they make through sports, they should prudently manage them so that it can serve them in their old age. However, there's nothing wrong in municipal sports like giving them a cover. In any case, these are people who have marketed this nation without the government spending much money. You can imagine how much money we are spending on KTB, promoting Kenya, Magical Kenya. They are spending billions of shillings. But Magical Kenya, KTB and all these others cannot market Kenya the way Eliud Kipchoge stopped the world for under 2 hours. The whole world was watching Eliud Kipchoge. It's an opportunity for Kenya to manage. So what is a big deal if government decides to give every legend even a medical cover of 2 million? Yes. I mean, it's just a drop in the sea compared to what they are bringing. In fact, all the money we are using for branding and marketing Kenya, if we can use sports, I think we shall even reach more nations and more people globally than the current arrangement where we are hiring some BBC fellows there and so forth.
So what would be your proposal to KTB, who are currently handling athletes and the image?
KTB should use our sports. Instead of spending our money paying PPC and others and other TV stations out there, let's take all our sportsmen and women from all disciplines, whether athletics, rugby. We have people who have done very well in skiing. We have people who have done very well in the past in things like cricket. You know, if we can use those ones, one, we shall be retaining the money in the country. Two, we shall be helping them to live their life better. And three, we shall be still reaching to our desired market globally.
Yes, thank you so much, Bwana Governor, for your time, and all the best in your plans of putting up infrastructure that will uplift athletics in the country and the globe as well.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yes, and of course, where the celebrations are happening and the sports years is touring the KDF stand. The sports series is being shown at the KDF stand, where has been a big bedrock of Kenyan talent and Kenya's first athlete who ever won a gold medal. Naftali Tem also belonged to KDF. And the role also reads like who's who in Kenya's athletics. This is the national police stand where previous medalists has produced medals and continues to.
you are the best. We normally come for ourselves, Team Kenya. And I think the president can bear me witness.
Madam, as you can see, in 3,000 meter steeplechase, the world record holder is an officer from Kenya Police Service. That is Beatrice Chepkoech. So we are proud of her. When you come down here, you can see Kipchoge, the doctor. He was a product of National Police Service. He was an instructor in Kenya Police College by then. So we are proud of him. And that is where we started thinking that we can go far. Next here, you can see Julius Yego, senior sergeant, well known as YouTube. I know you've seen her several times. He was the first Kenyan to win in an unfilled event, that is in Olympics. And that was a wonderful job. You can see our team here. It went to Asaba. The four of them, this was a relay team, was from National Police Service. The Janet Chepkosgei, the Eldoret Express, from our National Police Service, Vivian Cheriot, Kemboy, as you can see. We have the late Nicholas Bate, who was the first police officer to go to represent the country and win a technical event. That is 400 meter saddles, which was the best, and we are proud of her. And may his soul rest in peace. You have the Pamela Chelimo, 800 meters. She did very well. I know you know her history. Okay, madam, in this side, we also have a 800 meters world record holder. That is David Rudisha. He's from the National Police Service. We are happy for her. We have the late Wanjiru, Samuel Wanjiru. He was the first Kenyan to win a gold in Olympic Games. But we are sorry we lost him. We have Ellen Isabella Ochichi. She's from National Police Service. Milka Chemos, she's here. Yeah. We are proud of her and we are happy. She made a good step and we are following her steps. We have Matelong. We have Matelong in steeplechase. We have the team which was a 3,000 meter championship 2019 steeplechase. Yeah. So madam, welcome. As you can see there, I wanted to finish here because you know the doctor. I know you've met him before in the other tents. He was here physically, but he's gone for another meeting. We are proud of him. He really made us realize that being a police officer is not only to deal with security, but we can go far in sports. And that's where we are today, and we thank our legend. Again, madam, you know, all this success, it was through the help or with the, in working together with Athletics Kenya, because we cannot do it alone. And we really say thank you, Athletics Kenya. Yes. Madam, God bless you. And we request for a photo.
Yes, and that was the Athletics Kenya, the KDF stand, giving up the update on what's happening and showcasing on what they've been able to achieve over that particular period that they've been representing the country or producing athletes who've been able to bring Kenya gold and do Kenya proud on international championships. And a couple of athletes, including Isabella Ochichi, as well as the first man to win a world championship gold medal in the hurdles event, the late Bates, and as well as David Rudisha, who won Kenya gold in the 2012 London Olympic Games in the 800 meters, as well as recording that outstanding time that still stands today. That's 1 minute 40.91 seconds. Yes, and of course, that's where the last one here will be. The CS will be touring the National Police Service stand, which will be the last stop in her one or two of the various towns to 12 regions and four institutions that make up the athletics Kenya. Of course, on show here, been various capable men and women who've done the country proud. And on the National Police Service, I can see they're all reading like who is who in this particular event.
Jambo, madam.
Oh, how are you?
I'm good, madam.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much, madam. You're welcome. Here we have our head coach in the Kenya Prisons. He's Gideon Shechil. He was a Stipoche's competitor, and he has won a lot of medals in the 3,000 meters. He has won a silver medal in the Stipoche's. Yes, sir. Next, we have Stephen Mwaniki. He's our coach for sprint. He's the head coach for sprint. And he's also my coach. He's the one who discovered my talent. Next to him, yes, madam. Next to him, we have Timothy Cheluyot. He's our current 1500 meters gold medalist in the past World Championships in Doha. And they are here to represent the Kenya Prisons, madam.
Congratulations to you as well.
Yes, madam. And here, we have our regions. All these regions, that's where we normally compete against ourselves to be able to get a strong team to represent Kenya Prisons during the national championship. And here we have our past champions. From 60s to the 1970, we have the famous Julius Sang and Robert Ouko, who participated in 400 by 4 relays in 1972 Olympics. They brought gold. And also we have Madam Mary Wagaki, who represented Kenya. She was the first African woman to participate in the Olympics marathon. And that is the lady that I took over from the Kenya Prisons, madam. Next, we have 1980s to year 2000. We have myself here as the world champion for two world championships, 2003 and 2007, and also Olympic silver medalist in 2004 and 2008. And also we have first African woman to win the world cross country championships, Helen Chemgeno, in 1994 in Budapest, Hungary. We also have our first African woman who won first silver medal in 1996 Olympics in 5,000 meters. She's Porin Cheponga, Porin Konga. And in 2000, and the millennium up to date, we have Timothy Cheluyot. The group is led by Timothy Cheluyot as our world gold medalist in 15,000 meters. We have the rest, like the youngest champion here is Selfin Chespol, who is an African world youth champion.
Very good.
Yes, madam. Yes, madam. You can feel welcome
of all the places we have gone. I think we want to congratulate Kenya Prisons for the presentation. Even the board is well organized.
Yes.
So, madam, yes. I've also done benchmark.
Thank you very, very much. Thank you. Yes, and inside here, madam, we have our past champions. And this is our history of what has been going on in the Kenya Prisons. Like this one is the richest. Yes, madam. And we have our past champions. Like this is Lucas Kibet. He won gold in the World Marathon in 2007 in Osaka. And here is Commissioner General and Timothy Cheluyot and myself while we are in uniform, madam. And next here, this is one of our events that normally take place. Like this was last year when we were having our cross country championships in January. We have our Madam Pierce, she was starting the race. Next is our Commissioner General, Mr. Wikrifu Ogalo. Yes, madam. And here we have a race for our senior officers. During our championships, we always have a curtain laser. And madam, you are most welcome for our next event.
Absolutely.
You can come and learn with our senior officers and also Madam Pierce. Madam, feel welcome. Yeah, so next, This is Selfie. She's our youngest champion, and she's the one who won the African Championships cross country. Who's next? Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is Madame Pierce presenting the trophy to the team, the winning team, during cross country championships. And here we have this trophy was honored. Mr. Ben Jipcho was offered this cup in 1973 as the Sportsman of the Year by BBC. And next to it is 880 yards. From 1954, we have all the past winners, the champions up to 1960. Next to it, we have the cup for the javelin and the winner from 1955 to 1957. Next to it, we have the 3,000 meters from 1965. The winner was Corporal Erisha. And next to it, it's for Athletic Association Challenge for the CGP, and for 100 yards. The winners from 1957 to 1965. Yes, madam. Karibu sana.
Asante sana.
Yeah. So, and it's my humble request, madam, that you sign for this. Thank you.
Thank you. Yes, and of course, the CS going through the National Prisons elite and active since where they've showcased athletes who've given the particular member of Athletics Kenya a name over their time. And of course, Catherine Ndereba, who was recently honored by the state for her achievement in sport by being bestowed with the MBS by President Uhuru Kenyatta during the Jamhuri Day celebrations. And also on the roll here, she is a world champion who also won Olympic silver medals in 2004 and 2008. They see us signing the visitors or guests a book after her brief tour of the AK Athletics Kenya marks 7 years of existence since it was founded in 1950, and the milestones that have been achieved are many record that top of the range, but there remains more and more miles to be trudged or trodden, if you could like. And we could be heading to yes, and and as the Jack Tuwei, the current AK chairman, who took the reins in 2015 from the late Isaiah Kiplagat. And of course, Isaiah Kiplagat being the seventh chair for the Olympics. Explaining the troubles and the achievements that the team reached at the particular event.
Sir Derek Esken, 1915 to 1964. And he's the one who donated this land where Nyayo Stadium stands today. That was his land. And this is Archie Evans, who was the Secretary General, as I've just shown there. Now, the first African from 1964, he took over from Sir Derek Esken to 1968, Musembi Mbathi. And after Musembi Mbathi, we had Baratonji Rotich, 1968 to 1972. And he was also a former, in fact, all these were former athletes. Musembi Mbathi, Baratonji Rotich. Baratonji Rotich handed over to Charles Mukora, 1972 to 1974. And Charles Mukora handed over to... Honorable Professor Sam Mungeri, 1974 to 1984. And, here he is. Welcome, welcome.
I'm the one who built this Nyayo Stadium.
Exactly. Yes. And then he handed over to Paul Boyd. Yeah. You remember Paul Boyd? Madam was the PC Western, later on PC Nairobi.
Yes. Then he
became chairman in 1984 to 1992. And then
also 8 years.
Yeah, 8 years. Then he handed over to the immediate past chairman or president. Now we started calling the president thereafter, to Isaiah Kiplagat, who was there from 1992 to 2015, 23 years.
And before that, my secretary.
Yes.
For 10 years.
Right. He was your secretary for 10 years.
Yes. Exactly.
So he's been in athletics. He's the longest in athletics. And then from there I took over. What is it? Can you explain very quickly how you make music? I know you know, madam, how music is made, but
this
very
is
quickly.
Actually some of the food our athletes love to eat, and the most important one is music. And this is what they use, a special tree done for, you know, making the duck. The charcoal, and it is also very nice because it gives a good bacteria in the stomach, and it makes their bones strong, and also it helps them to have radicals, free radicals, especially when they take fruits and our indigenous greens called saga. The mostly the kisses use. And it's very nice because they give the minerals and others. Welcome.
Thank you.
Madam, this is a bamboo tree, but it was used for pole vault before the flexible one came in. People were using this to jump football pole vault. Of course, you remember this very well.
I love that one.
The starter.
That was our old gun.
This is an old gun, and it has been there for a long time. And these were the relay buttons,
yes.
Which we used for a long time before the others. This one now came,
yes.
And now I think we have even a newer one.
Okay.
This 1992, this was our logo from 1952. When we got the constitution up to 2002, 50 years. Now, when we come here, long jump, triple jump, people used to use sawdust. Then they used, later, it was actually grass, and then sawdust, and then now we have come to the sand, the fine sand from the auction. And of course, they used to jump without even any marking. But now, later on, they started marking triple jump, long jump. So that's the development of athletics. Now, these are the javelins. That was the vest for the All African Games, 1987. Yeah. Now, when you come to shot put, people were using stones to start throwing a shot put. Now we have come to the actual stone itself. And that's the development. These were used by Lydia Steven. You remember the lady we met there?
Yeah, the special guest.
Yes. So she's the one who used this during the Mexico Olympics in 1968, and she still has got them. A very interesting thing. Then this was the medal of Hezekiah Nyamau in 1972, where he won in Munich by 400 meters. This was the one for Chemabwa in 1972, and 1974. This was a Julia Sang medals. They have also given. That was the one for the All African Games, which was won with that one. This was the 1968 Mexico Olympics uniform, Kenyan uniform. That was won by Kina Kipchoge, Naftali Temu, Ben Chipcho, and the rest. It is still very, very nice. These are the other medals by the athletes. Now, this was the great team that ran the 4x4 in Munich 1972, where Charles Asati started. He handed over the baton to Hezekiah Nyamau. Hezekiah Nyamau handed over to Robert Ouko, and Robert Ouko handed over to Julia Sang. And they brought gold, the only gold we have ever won in the Olympics 4x400 meters. These are other medals for Asati. They have actually donated some of this. So up to there, madam, that has been the development from the beginning. But now, the current, where are we currently? Because it's been a journey. It's a long journey. So we have the federation that was nominated the other day. And we want to thank you for having walked with us to where we have been. Now we are doing the 70 years celebration. That is the current state of affairs in Athletics Kenya today. And finally, in the current state, again state, current is Valencia, which was on the 7th November, just actually last week. And these are the results where we achieved those in the Valencia half marathon and full marathon. So that is where we are. This is Tegla Jemabwai. This is Elizabeth Chesire. Of course, you met Lydia Stevens. Great.
And yeah, I saw your shoes.
Great ladies. Great ladies who have done a lot for this country. And they are still going strong. Thank you so much.
They can see them when they were small, they are here.
Hmm? You want that to be done now? Okay. Maybe as we...
Yes, and that was the Athletics Kenya president, Jack Tuwei, taking through the sports years, Ambassador Amina Mohammed, through the achievement of Kenya's athletes as we celebrate the 70 years of athletics. And of course, we've seen the all-conquering 1972, beg your pardon, team. Yes, and of course, I was talking about the all-conquering 1972 team, of Hezekiah Nyamau, Robert Ouko, Charles Sati, as well as Julius Sang, who were able to bring Kenya gold, and the only gold that still stands today. And of course, among the memorabilia or artifacts that have been on show today, we've seen the logo for Athletics Kenya, which stood for 50 years between 1952 to 2002, and also a role of former chairman who have held the mantle of this particular federation from the time it was formed in 1950 up to date, and eight of them have mirrored the federation's success. And probably the history of the Olympics, the last three editions of the Olympic Games, 2008, 2012, as well as 2016, have been the most successful for Team Kenya at the Games. But of course, our first ever medal at the Games was in 1968. And we'll be speaking to Nyeri Governor Mutahi Kahiga. Asante sana bwana governor kwa kujiunga nasi wa KBC Channel 1 wakati huu ambapo shirikisho la riadha nchini AK linaadhimisha miaka 70 ya kuwepo na vile vile kuinua kiwango cha riadha nchini. Mojawapo wa wale wanachama wa shirikisho hili na labda bwana governor, unaweza tuelezea ni nini haswa unajivunia katika historia riadha humu nchini wakati ambapo maadhimisho haya miaka 70 yanafanyika?
Asante sana. Ni kweli kwamba siku ya leo tunaadhimisha miaka 70 tangu chama cha riadha kibuniwe katika taifa hili, na kuna mambo mengi ambacho tunaweza kujidaia kwa sababu Kenya mzima ulimwengu mzima, jina la Kenya linapotajwa kila mmoja anafahamu kwamba ni riadha. Tukiangalia katika tarakimu unaona kwamba taifa la Kenya katika michezo ya Olimpiki limeweza kujishindia medali 103. Kati ya medali hizo 103, 97 ni zile ambazo zimetokana na riadha. Kwa hivyo ni kuonyesha kwamba kiwango hiki cha riadha kimeweza kusukumwa vizuri sana na chama cha riadha. Na ni vizuri tena tuseme kwamba chama hiki cha riadha ni mmoja wapo ya vyama vichache sana ambavyo katika taifa hili havina mzozo, havina vurugu, havina ufujaji wa pesa za umma, na kimeendelea kuwa managed ama kuendelezwa kwa njia ambayo inafaa. Na ndipo tunaweza kusema kwamba siku ya leo tuko hapa tusherekee, tufurahie, na tukumbuke kwamba pia riadha ni mojawapo ya vitengo ambavyo vinaboresha uchumi wetu. Ukitaka kujua, fika Eldoret uone jinsi wanariadha walivyojenga majumba makubwa, uende Nyahururu na kwingineko, unapata kwamba pia imekuwa ni kama cha kuleta kimeinua uchumi wetu. Kwa hivyo kwangu mimi ni kuchukua nafasi hii kuwatakia kila laheri, hasa viongozi na rais wa chama hicho General Tuwei na timu yake ambao wameendeleza. Na niseme nimekuja hapa kwa sababu mwanzo nilikuwa pia mwanariadha, na pia nimekuwa mmoja wa wale ambao wamekuwa wakiendeleza riadha kabla ya kwenda kuwa gavana katika jimbo la Nyeri.
Naam, na wana michezo wengi tu kimo na riadha, labda gavana anauliza Ruringu imefikia wapi?
Ruringu inaendelea vizuri. Tuasema ni project ambao tumeshika sisi na serikali kuu. Serikali kuu wanajenga ndani, mimi najenga ukuta karibu tuumalize, na pia mle ndani sehemu zile sasa tunajenga bustani mahali ambapo watu watakuwa wakiketi, lakini tayari katika sehemu ya kukimbilia hiyo imejengwa kwa sasa.
Na ukarabati labda unaweza sema utaenda ukamalize?
Siwezi nikasema kwa sababu kuna mambo mengi ambayo yametuadhiri, hasa katika mambo ya COVID, pengine kuna shida na matatizo ya fedha, lakini nina uhakika kwamba kufikia mwezi Juni tutakuwa tumekamilisha kazi ile.
Asante sana bwana governor. I've been speaking to Nyeri County Governor, former also member of the Athletics Kenya, who held Adminster, and maybe one of the 100 plus goals that we've been speaking about. He played a big role in making sure that Kenya wins. Maybe one of the sticking issues that have come in the previous time of this particular administration of athletics in the country has been maybe the switching of nationalities as well as doping, the two sticking issues that maybe have shaken the federation, not to the core, but really they've drawn them to the drawing board, and it has sprung them to doing a lot in terms of maybe remuneration as well as intensifying their efforts to and also intensifying their efforts to fight doping. And yesterday, speaking to AK President Jack Tuwei, he talked about intensifying the effort as well as doing that what's required so as to fight. And of course, this is heading to the entering the Nyayo National Stadium, the main focus, main venue for today's 70th celebrations at the Nyayo National Stadium. Of course, and CS going through the various regions here that form AK, and of course she's gone through the 14 of them, yes, 14 four institutions as well as the 12 institutions and regions that make the Athletics Kenya. We be handing you over to Amfa PD on the other side of the broadcast to fill you in on what's happening on the other side. Of course, what do we expect from here after the CS has toured the 12 stands or stalls that are on show here? We expect the athletes who are seated, we'll be able to give you the pictures in a short while. The athletes are seated, the 60 of them who have been invited, and we're talking about the athletes who represent Kenya in the 1950s. Those are the pioneers. They are the pioneers. They are the icons. We have the legends. So which class do you place them? 50s, 60s, 70s, as well as the 80s group who did the country proud and gave the particular federation this rich and enchanting history, athletics history. Thank you so much. We join Amfa PD on the other side of the broadcast.
Thank you very much, Bernard Okumu, for that good work taking us around with what's been happening from the stands. Remember, it's happening live from the Nyayo National Stadium, courtesy of your true sports partner, that's KBC Channel 1, the CS of Sports. Ambassador Amina Mohamed going through the different stands, of course, at the different regions, and looking at some of the big state corporates that have brought up this rivalry in athletics, talking about of course Kenya Defense Forces, National Police Service, Kenya Prisons. Kenya Prisons are led there by the great Catherine Dereba, one of the pioneer ladies in the country. Very, very interesting indeed to see some of the former athletes here at the stadium. And of course, the chief guest for the afternoon is CS Sports Ambassador Amina Mohamed, who's already taken her seat, accompanied there by Ambassador, retired Lieutenant General Jackson Tuwei, who is the current AK Athletics Kenya president. Just to run you through what plans are there for the afternoon is, of course, there'll be prayers. After that, a short presentation.
Remove it
Ladies and gentlemen, all for right, those who have at this point, kept,
let's
you.
Join in and just be part of the AK celebrations, the national anthem of Kenya. Okay.
Prison Service, thank you very much. Very quickly, I just want to appreciate the presence of, kindly sit down. We want to appreciate the presence of a number of key dignitaries, of course led by Ambassador Mohamed Amina Mohamed. We have Professor Sam Ongeri, who is the senator of Kisii. And the reason why Sam Ongeri is here, and we appreciate it, is because he has a lot of interest in athletics, having been the chairman of Athletics Kenya from 1974 to 1984, for a decade. Secondly, we have the governor of Uasin Gishu, Mr. Mandago, and we have another governor of Nyeri, Mutahi Kahiga. I hope he has come in. I saw him outside. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, dignitaries, past athletes and present athletes, karibuni, feel at home. And the reason why we are here is because of you, the athletes. Karibuni. So very quickly, we want to invite Madam Catherine Dereva, who is former world champion marathon in 2005 Helsinki. And she doubles up as the assistant commissioner at Kenya Prison Service. Karibu, Catherine. So she will lead us for a word of prayer, then we can move on. Thank you.
Yeah. For those who can be able to stand, let us have a word of prayer. Our God and our Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we want to thank you. We want to honor you and to magnify your holy name, Jehovah, because of whom you are. We adore you, King of all kings and the Lord of lords. We acknowledge that, Jehovah God, there is no one like thee, Almighty Father. We want to worship you, Jehovah, because of thy goodness, thy mercies, O Jehovah Father, that is eternal. How we thank you, how we honor you, my Lord, because of this far that you have brought us, King of all the glory. We want to acknowledge that this far, Jehovah Father, you are our Ebenezer. How we thank you, how we honor you. This day, O King of all kings and the Lord of lords, we want to acknowledge that my Father and my God, it could not be possible without you. Thank you for your grace. Thank you for your mercy. Jehovah Father, we acknowledge that this is the day that you have made, that we may be, that we may rejoice and be glad in it. We thank you and we honor you. We want to thank you, Jehovah Father, For this far, Jehovah God, you have seen through our sportsmen and women, O dear King of all the glory. For all those years, my Father, we are celebrating the 70 years of athletics in our nation. My Father and my God, if it were not for your hand upon our lovely nation, King of all kings and the Lord of lords, this could not be possible. Receive all the glory, receive all the honor, power, and adoration in the mighty name of Jesus. Today, my Lord and my God, I want to lift our nation unto your able hands. Thank you, Father, King of all kings and the Lord of lords. You are the Prince of Peace, my God. Without your peace, my Jehovah, we could not be this far, oh God. We don't take it for granted, my Lord, that we enjoy peace in our nation. Sports could be this far, oh God, without your mercies, without the peace that you have bestowed upon our nation. I want to thank you for our leaders, oh God. May you bless them. May you do them good, oh Father. Jehovah Master, I pray that you may grant them wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. And moreover, my Father, that you may grant them the spirit of discernment as they continue to lead us, oh God, that they may lead us according to thy will. We thank you and we honor you, O Jehovah God. We want to thank you for our CS, O King of all the glory, and all other CSs who have ever been there supporting sports in this nation. My God and my Father, they have been supporting our heroes and our heroines, O God. How we thank you, how we honor you, O King of all kings and the Lord of lords. Without the motivation that they give those heroes and heroines, O God, sports in Kenya, my Father, could not be this far. We thank you and we worship you. My Lord and my God, I want to lift the leadership of our athletics, Kenya, unto your able hands, my Father. It has taken you, oh God, for them to be able to work tirelessly, my Father. Jehovah God, we are not taking it for granted that you have been with them, that they have been able to be pillars of sports in this nation. We thank you and we honor you. How we pray for long life for our leaders, O King of all the glory, that they may continue to support us, O God. My Lord and my God, I want to commit all the heroes and the heroines, the sportsmen and women of this country, my Father, the old and the young, O God. My Father, I leave them unto you. Bless them and do them good, O God. My Father and my Master, I pray for their families, King of all kings and the Lord of lords. I pray that you may cover each and every one of them with the blessings, O Jehovah, that addeth no sorrow. We thank you and we honor you. My Lord and my God, we are not taking it for granted that Jehovah Father, such a day we are here, my God. The plans of the evil one is to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But my Father and my God, you have seen us through this far. Jehovah King of all kings, you have preserved our lives. Even to be able to gather here together such a day as this, oh God, we are not taking it for granted. Receive glory, receive honor, power, and adoration in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. My Lord and my God, this day, as we celebrate the 70th anniversary of athletics in this nation, my God and my Father, I want to leave the sportsmen and women of this nation, and especially our future generation, oh God. My Father and my God, how I pray that you may help them, oh Father, to train and to do the activities in truth, my Father. Jehovah God, I want to rebuke and to cancel the spirit of lies, oh God, where we have our sportsmen and women, oh Lord, lying, oh Jehovah Master, by doping. We cancel that evil in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We pray that you may instill the spirit of truth in our sportsmen and women, oh God, that when they compete, my Father, they compete with a lot of cleanness, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We thank you and we honor you. As we continue with the activities of this day, oh God, we commit everything unto your able hands. Guide us and direct us, and may your presence abide with us. For this is our prayer of faith, and it is in Jesus' mighty name we do pray and give thanks. Amen.
Good. Thank you very much, Catherine Ndereva. Apart from being a super athlete, Catherine is, in terms of mambo ya Mungu, she is deep state kwa mambo ya Mungu. Yani, Catherine is serious with her religion. Thank you. Sasa hata mimi nimeokoka hapa. Thank you. So, very quickly, so that we move fast, first of all, I want to start with to appreciate the presence of Major General Fatuma Hamed. I hope you've taken your seat. Major Generali is here to represent Lieutenant General Robert Kibochi, who is the Army Commander. So very quickly, just to take a minute, we want to first of all tell our chief guest that in organizing this event, the AK had a challenge in inviting all our Kenyan athletes, because we have so many athletes from the 80s, 90s to now. So it took a stand to honor for its 70th anniversary, to honor the athletes from 1980 going backwards. And that is why you can see that we have the athletes from the 60s, the 70s, until 1980. And very quickly, to appreciate some of them who are here, we will just, before I call Mr. Bosire, I want to just quickly appreciate them in passing. We have a long list of them. Billy Conchella, John Gugi, Susan Sirma, Sema Jambo, Richard Juma, Sema Jambo, Fetuel Kimayo, Wilson Kibrugut Chuma, Sema Jambo Wilson. He was the first athlete to win an Olympic title in 1964. So we have a long list of athletes. Julius Karaoke is seated there, winner of Olympics in 88, steeplechase. Rosa Tamuya, we have Ruth Waithera, who was the first woman to run in the Olympic Games finals, 400 meters. So we have a long list. Dr. Ezekiah Kipchoge Keino, where is he? He's here. He was the most celebrated runner of his time. Paul Tergat, he's somewhere in the stand. Sema Jambo, 5 times world cross country. Ibrahim Kipkemboi Hussein, we have seen him here. I can't mention all of you. And for today's runners, David Rudisha, where is he? David, simama useme tu Jambo. Jambo, there he is. So we have a mix of runners. And we will call you for the presentations. Helen Obiri, current world champion from Doha, where is she? She's there. Sema Jambo, Helen. So we have a mix of athletes, and we appreciate that you have come here. So very quickly, let me give Celestine to move forward from there.
Well, as you've heard, ladies and gentlemen, this is a very big celebration today. We are celebrating the foundation of athletics, and we are celebrating the current athletes as well as the future athletes. And, you know, one of the interesting things I've heard today is that David Rudisha was telling me how he is excited to see Wilson Kiprugut Chuma, the first Kenyan to win an Olympic gold. Because when he was growing up, his late father would tell him a lot about Wilson Kiprugut. So it is very good to have them finally get to meet here today as well. I know he's met him before, I am sure, David, I believe. Yes, he has. Yeah. So thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Before we get Mr. David Biano here, Athletics Executive Committee member, to announce the next part of the program, I'd just like to remind us all, we live in difficult times, the pandemic, and as you have seen, there is protocol that we are supposed to be following. There are men and women here who have volunteered to help us make sure we are keeping with the COVID-19 protocols. Ladies and gentlemen, please Listen to them. Remember, keep your masks on. I have mine here. Don't say I'm just saying that for the sake of it. Sanitize and maintain social distance. In fact, one of our volunteers for the COVID-19 team is a former world marathon record holder, Patrick Macau. You see? So, ladies and gentlemen, it is a full house athletics. Mr. David Miano, please.
Honorable Abazda Mina Mohammed, the governors who are with us today, Governor Wasangishu, His Excellency Madago, Governor Nyeri, His Excellency Mutahi Kahiga, senators with us, particularly our former chairman of Afro Kenya, who is now a senator of Kisi, Honorable Ongeri, government officials with us today, visitors we have invited outside Kenya, particularly the General Secretary, I think, of the Legion from Sudan, Mr. Sdik. I think we have visitors from elsewhere. All protocol observed. Allow me quickly, our chief guest, to go straight to as the chairman of the organizing committee of this arrangement, it was, like it was mentioned earlier, quite a task to get to know how we cut out this event. We found it finally necessary to put our focus, looking at our history of Athletic Kenya since foundation in 1950, we found it necessary amidst an enormous number of our athletes within that period of 70 years. We decided, like it was announced earlier by our MCA, to focus on the period 1950 to 1970 mainly. Therefore, our chief guest, most of the ones who happen to have done duty for this country within that period will feature a lot in today's arrangement. Nevertheless, we have also factored in from 1980, those who took over, like it was once again mentioned, starting with the likes of John Gugge, the president of NOC Kenya, Paul Talgat, and the rest, a few of them that we have brought on board just to represent the era from 1980 onward, who are once again so many. Now, from 1950 to 1979, we found our list to start with amounted to over 1,000. Then we could not be able to ferry 1,000 number here. We decided finally as a committee, and of course with a ratification from Athletic Kenya, to finally zero down to medalists ranging from 1950, the first event, starting with the first team that went out. Our chief guest, I know you've been taken through even the stories of the first team ever to be constituted and went out to Canada. They went by sea for 1 month. All these stories, I think, has been narrated to you. Therefore, we zeroed down to medalists only. Plus maybe a few world cards given by Athletic Kenya due to special performances and the uniqueness. We have also tried to balance men and women. Amidst the huge number we had, we decided to balance men and women so that at least we can, at least for once, appreciate those men and women who did duty for this country, same way those who are there today have done. I therefore would like our chief guest to welcome you and all seated today here and the rest of the country to observe a documentary of a few minutes that will feature performances of, once again, our focus. those ones who did duty for the country since 1950. We may not have captured all within our documentary. It's a huge, huge undertaking. But then we have condensed it to like a 20-minute roundup that will show our development since that period in question. Therefore, please welcome to this documentary, after which we'll roll over to the next part of this program. Want to thank all those, because I will not start here again, all those who are involved in arrangement of this event, particularly my committee. Want to thank Athletic Kenya for giving us that chance. Want to thank our sponsors, particularly Lotto, who are very hardy in this arrangement. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Well, Athletics Kenya, I think just continue doing what you're doing. Continue doing it and improving it every day. I use the latest technology, I think, to communicate, to educate, to create awareness, a focus on the things that can let us down, and doping is one of them. And I think that together with Athletics Kenya, the ministry has continued to create awareness among the athletes to talk about doping, to make sure that it's understood that it's something that we will not tolerate and that we will deal with going forward. And we intend to actually criminalize it, and we're working on that. And we're working very, very actively on it. So nobody should ever think that we won't deal with it conclusively. So I think that they should just continue, just improving. I think that nothing is ever perfect, right? And it just depends on how we improve, we use whatever comes in latest, and make sure that that tunnel of athletes never dries up. You know, we need to go to primary schools, secondary schools, and just make sure that we develop talent. There's no question in my mind that the talent that we have in this country is amazing. The potential that is there is wonderful. And that by investing in it, by investing in our youth, we'll be able as a country to continue enjoying the successes that they bring to the table. They'll continue creating an image for our country, an image of stability, of endurance, and of staying the course, working on that. And we're working very, very actively on it. So nobody should ever think that we won't deal with it conclusively. So I think that they should just continue just improving. I think that nothing is ever perfect, right? And it just depends on how we improve, we use whatever comes in latest, and make sure that that tunnel of athletes never dries up. You know, we need to go to primary schools, secondary schools, and just make sure that we develop talent. There's no question in my mind that the talent that we have in this country is amazing. The potential that is there is wonderful. And that by investing in it, by investing in our youth, will be able as a country to continue enjoying the successes that they bring to the table. They'll continue creating an image for our country, an image of stability, of endurance, and of staying the course.
Tulifanya spoti ambayo ilikuwa ya kwa Resafa hapo kwetu. Ilikuwa kwa mchezo ya mwaka. Nikawa mtu ambayo napenda spoti. Nilikuwa napenda. Nilipoletea mama Brigitte, nasema shukuru. Meshukuru. Tukaingia sasa Olympic 1964. kweli kwa tu namna sport na watu ndio wengi nataka kuangalia wewe lakini nilijaribu nikaona bwana tafadhali hit ya pili ndio pole nikachukua nikaona bwana kichoga ikapigwa kumbu hago kwa uno kwenye ya final.
In 1964, we had the Olympic Games in Tokyo, and I went to represent the country in Tokyo. But I didn't win the medal, I was fourth. I didn't know the other men went through, and I missed bronze or silver, very, very close. Well, in 1968, we had Olympic in Mexico. And in Mexico, I was told by the doctor not to run, but I said the doctor, I was a team captain of the Kenya team. I told the doctor, listen, I came here to run. If anything happened, I don't care, let me run. So I did run. I could not finish the 10,000 meters, I collapsed, and Naftali Tema won. And then 5,000 meters, I finished, I went to silver. 1,500 meters, I won, with about 20 meters ahead of the other people, I won a gold. In 1972, we had Olympic Games in Germany. Munich, and I represent the country in 3,000 meters steeplechase and 1,500. I won a gold in 1,500, you know, in the 3,000 meters. I came home with a silver in the 1,500 meters.
1964, in Tokyo, nilianza kukimbia. Mimi mtu wa kwanza kukimbia steeplechase. Yo mjeso ilikuwa mkeni. 1968 kwa Kenya ilikuwa meongezeka. Tulikuwa na kina Kipchoge na mimi ni Pengogo na Naftali Temu, Marehemu, Mukisi. Tulikuwa na Kiprugut Wilson Kiprugut. Iko anakaa bande ya Kericho. Hivi hata jipyo ilikuwa kwa marehemu tulikuwa naye moja.
Nilishiriki katika mchezo ya mita 3,000 ya kuruka maji katika mji wa Mexico 1968 na nikashinda dhahabu. Timu yetu